Oh, hello there. Didn't see you. We're just sitting here making a ramp for our new trailer. And I haven't shown you this trailer just yet. But guess what? When we get done building these ramps for this trailer, I'm about to show you our new investment, Gertrude. And the reason why she's Gertrude, because she's an old gal. Girl, when I break you off, I promise that you won't wanna get off. Trying to get these ramps ready because my trailer, when we bought the trailer, it didn't come with ramps. And you're gonna be like, well, why didn't you buy a trailer with ramps? Because it was cheaper, damn it. It's cheaper to make these than it is to go to freaking, what is it called, Tractor Supply or Harbor Freight. Yeah, I was checking on them prices. They tried to screw you for some aluminum. Metal went up, but wood went up. But luckily, I had this kicking around. After we built this deck,
alright everybody, so we got the ramps built. Looks really good. I think it should work. Shouldn't have no problems working on it. But I wanted to show you Gertrude, our 1988 car trailer. I wanted a closed-in trailer. But the thing about having an open trailer is that it draws more attention with the car on it. So it'll draw more people to look at the channel because I have all the stickers on the side and everything. So everybody's like, oh man, I like that car, you know, dang, oh, well, let's follow him. You know what I mean? That's the thought behind it. But anyway, this is a 1988 trailer that we picked up for a really good deal for what it is. You know, it's got the D-hooks on the, it's got all the D-hooks on it and everything, so we'll be able to tie down the vehicle from the bottom, you know, from the bottom of the trailer instead of just to the sides, where sometimes it can be very hard to get a good tie down. So that just makes it a little bit easier. Anyway, so what I'm going to do is we'll get the thermostat together, and I'm going to take the thermostat out of this, and then I'm going to put it back together, put some gasket sealer on it, and that'll be it. So it'll be on like Donkey Kong. Alright, anyway. But yeah, bear with me. We're going to get this done, and then we're going to be racing here pretty soon.
Our drag strip in Timber Lake, North Carolina. About to go down this track if I get this DLC belt on. There we go. I'm getting fat. There we go. Alright. I won't be doing no video indoor footage. I didn't bring my damn GoPro. So everything's going to be all outside of the track and over to the side. See you there. Thank you.
Alright, so we lost to the Fox body. Anyway, but ran my consistent 8.1 times, 1.8 60 foot. We got to get the 4-tier gears in so we can beat that time. I'm trying to keep it from stalling out on the line, because I'm still having some issues with the heat and don't know what it is. Still trying to figure it out. But anyway, we're going to make another test run and see where it goes from there. All right, so we're about to run again, maybe in the next 10 to 15 minutes. Hopefully the car cools down enough. I pulled it up. We've been pushing it all the way to the top for when to stage up. But I don't care how long it takes them to get this track ready.
Looks like they're in the final stages. Getting this start line and track ready for these cars and trucks. Y'all just hang tight. Just
so they're cleaning the track. They're getting it prepped. What I'm going to do is just keep it doing what it do. Keep it cool. And then hopefully it'll run a good time. I took a pound out of each tire. So I'm looking at 7 pounds per tire and see if that helps me hook better. We just don't know. I got the left lane last time, I did the right, and we'll see where it goes from there. Switch phones. I got some of the footage that I got with Pete's phone came through, but we're gonna switch up the phones, and I'm gonna give him mine. Last night was a little bit of success, a little bit of failure. The success was we didn't blow the car up. It got overheated on the last run that we were supposed to run, and I was staging up and I saw the temperature gauge rush forward to like 240, 250, 260. I said, man, I gotta back out of this. So I just decided to take off down the track. I didn't run it hard. Just drove it down, got it finished up, put it away. I said, it's not worth risking the motor for a race. So we just put it down, and then we took it down to put it up on the trailer and came on back to the house. So, but anyway, we're going to figure this out. I think I actually did figure out the overheating issue, but I'm going to go get that checked out, see if I can't get that done. I took some tips, hints, chemical agent that I could put in there called 40 Below. I've never even heard of it. surprisingly, but got some tips, got some tricks, and we're gonna go put that stuff in, order it, and then see if that helps with everything we have issues. And then we go get a 160 degree thermostat and see if that also helps as well. All right, guys, well, I'm gonna check it out, and I'll check y'all later. Come back and check out the channel, hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, and we're gonna go from here. All right, see you later. And while we're on the subject, Gertrude did a fantastic job. That was a success in its own. Gertrude just holding it down, sit there, pulled like a champ. She did a great job, and I'm happy about that. It was it drove down the road just fine, and so we're gonna spruce her up ourselves. So that's gonna be another little project we got going on. All right, guys. Anyway, see you later. Hope y'all have a wonderful day.